So, WoW Classic is officially back. It's back and bigger than ever, everyone. If you've ever played this game in the past, I highly suggest to start getting into it now and get that nostalgic feeling going on. If you haven't ever played this game, consider giving it a go because everybody is starting from scratch now. It's a great time to be getting into it. So, yeah, this is big news for a lot of gamers. World of Warcraft Classic actually launched Monday at 3 p.m. Pacific time. A little bit about it. Classic is a revamped version of the original version of World of Warcraft, and it's a huge hit around the community, like I just mentioned. Literally, it's the most viewed game right now on Twitch.
Which, speaking of, I will be live streaming pretty often on this game. If you want to watch the stream, feel free to check the description below for a link to my Twitch. You probably won't, but just thought I'd throw it out there just in case, you know, gotta plug it. Anywho, so yeah, this WoW Classic is based on version 1.12 of the game, which that was released all the way back in 2006. To put this in perspective, the modern World of Warcraft is now at version 8.2. Wowzers, right? They have been updating this game for a long time, very long time. And this was literally stated from Blizzard. World of Warcraft Classic is a faithful recreation of the original World of Warcraft. Same combat mechanics, original character models, player skills. It's truly an authentic experience if you've experienced it before. If you haven't, well, consider diving into it, especially now while once again everyone is starting over. It's a great time to be starting it. In case you didn't know, World of Warcraft was originally released back in 2004, but like I just mentioned, this version is based on version 1.12 of the game, which that update was released in 2006. The new version of the game, called Vanilla by longtime fans, was a curious one for many people. I mean, who wants to pay $13 to $15 a month just to play a more difficult version of a game that already has a lot of expansion packs? Well, it turns out, many do. In fact, like I just mentioned before, this is currently the most viewed game on Twitch at the moment. So yeah, it's even surpassing Fortnizzle and Minecraftio. And honestly, this seemed to be just a very honorable move by Blizzard to please their fans, and it worked in a phenomenal way for them. Not only do many fans get to engage in that nostalgic feeling, but there is also many new players who are starting this as well with players because why not? Everyone is pretty much a noob, right? Pretty much was the key words there because, yeah, not everyone. Ho, no. There's a select few who decide to grind endlessly to reach max level. Literally, there are players that have already gotten max level, which, by the way, the level cap is 60. I'm sure a lot of you saw this coming. It literally became a race between a ton of players as soon as this reset happened to see who would be the first player to reach level cap of 60. And well, it seems after about 79 hours of almost non-stop grinding, killing, and questing, a player named Jokerd has claimed the crown. So this guy was a machine with no sleep. Props to him, though. Big props to him. And yes, not only is he a robot, he is a Twitch streamer as well. The world's first race to 60 was an event that was coordinated by one of Warcraft's most famous guilds that goes by Method, who began live streaming Warcraft events last year when it raced to be the first to beat Battle for Xur'oth's newest raid. And, well, with the release of WoW Classic, which is pretty big for a lot of WoW players, of course, Method had to organize and invite notable players to race against. What was even more special about this is that he invited these players out to a Las Vegas studio, and these people would be providing commentary and gameplay over this race on Twitch. It was pretty cool. In my opinion, that is freaking awesome of the gaming community to do and set up. You know, you gotta love it when gamers come together like this. The crazy thing is, though, Jokerd wasn't one of those players that decided to stream in Las Vegas. He stayed right where he was to have full focus, I guess, on getting to that max cap. I mean, I'm not exactly sure why he decided not to go there, but yeah, he didn't end up going out there. Of course, most of his competition was, though. Which, the runner-up was actually a guy who goes by Kenny Marsh, who was level 55 by the time Jokerd won the competition. Close, but no cigar, Kenny. Maybe next time, buddy. Just kidding. There's not going to be another next time for quite some time. Actually, yeah, there will be, but it's going to be something totally different. I'll get more into that further in this video. Anyways, Jokerd was playing as a gnome mage, and he favored old-fashioned grinding to gain experience points. While other players tried out more advanced strategies like coordinating dungeon runs and whatnot, Jokerd instead spent a good chunk of time in the Western Plaguelands using his mage's frost abilities to draw the large groups of undead toward him and then freezing them in place and just smacking them with ice over and over. It was a pretty safe method.
A boring method, but safe. When he did reach level 60, a whopping 347,000 people on Twitch were watching. 347,000 people on Twitch. I know, right? Holy sh**. And get this, to get the last bit of experience that he needed, Jokerd abandoned his safe method and instead went to a nearby settlement and attacked a Scarlet Paladin who gave him the few hundred experience he actually needed. The moment it happened, the local chat channel, of course, exploded in cheers and congratulations. Immediately once he hit that 60 level cap, Jokerd teleported back to Stormwind City, where a mass of players quickly swarmed him to congratulate him in the actual game, which is pretty cool to think about. Yeah, they all swarmed around him just congratulating him on his win while the stream was still going on. And while all of this was going on, Jokerd played Celebration by Cool in the game. I mean, you can just check all of this out on his Twitch channel if you want, which I'll be leaving that also down below in the description. I mean, I don't see why you would want to go check out his channel instead of mine. I mean, come on. Just kidding, I suck. And believe it or not, actually it's pretty easy to believe because this seems to always happen, Jokerd's win has drawn a small amount of controversy from players who feel like he was exploiting the game system to gain an edge. The people who are complaining are probably just some sore losers, honestly. But it's seriously a thing right now. Hopefully it doesn't cause too much drama with him. Jokerd apparently abused this system called layering, which this is used to constantly switch to new instances of the area he was farming for experience. It would help him skip the long wait between monster respawns. And to get more into detail about this layering, WoW Classic has a system in their game that is called layering that helps spread players out across virtual instances of a zone to keep the population at a manageable size. It's a temporary countermeasure to prevent thousands of players from flooding a single area in the early months of Classic's launch. Jokerd used layering to constantly switch to new instances of the area he was farming for experience, helping him skip the long wait between monster respawns. While some players, you know, are taking issue with that, Method commentator JB pushed back by saying that using layering in this way was smart and that utilizing that for leveling is fair play as far as he's concerned. Which, that's great news. I mean, hey, if JB, the commentator for Method, is saying that it's fair use, then it probably won't get more blown out of proportion than it already has. Let's hope, anyways. I mean, after all, Method is the one that set up this race. Let's just hope it stays like this, because he literally took 79 hours of his life to do this. I mean, it's pretty impressive, I'm not gonna lie, though. He actually achieved this. He was the first person to hit that level 60 cap with the new WoW Classic. It's pretty cool, but that's seriously something that's going a little bit controversial with him, on whether or not he actually deserved this win of getting to level 60 first. And the runner-up was pretty close, he was 55. So, I mean, I don't know. At least the players in Method came out and said it was okay. Like I mentioned before, though, with Kenny about saying, you know, there's not going to be another next time. There actually is. There's going to be another race. Except this race is going to be between players who actually reached level 60. The next race will be to see who can clear the first wave of raids, including Onyxia's Lair and Molten Core. Both of these raids are not available yet, but might be in a few months when Blizzard rolls out the first major update to Classic. Until then, players will just be working hard to level their required characters to 60. Remember, raids back then required 40 people, and they all needed to be actually geared up. So yeah, this is going to be really interesting when this plays out. This is just the beginning of WoW Classic. Once again, if you're wanting to get into this, now is the time to be getting into it. It's a complete restart here. A Classic experience has long been demanded by fans after years of releasing new expansion packs and older content. Even WoW enthusiasts launched their own private servers that let players experience the vanilla game. Servers that prompted Blizzard to actually take legal action. These servers did get pretty big back in the day because that's how many fans actually just wanted to enjoy vanilla WoW. While Classic is supposed to bring back fond memories of original WoW experience, there are a few changes throughout the game. Classic will allow players to boost the graphics setting if you may want to do that. And get this, the vice president of Blizzard was actually letting fans know during BlizzCon in 2017 that the classic WoW was in development. It actually was a little metaphor that he did. He was like, in these exact words, "I want to talk about ice cream. Ice cream is great. Ice cream is actually one of my favorite desserts. Personally, I love chocolate and I love cookies and cream." He added, "Cookies and cream is actually my all-time favorite dessert. But I understand that for some of you, your favorite flavor is vanilla." And this was actually a reference to World of Warcraft fans. He then afterwards came out and said how the vanilla WoW will be having a complete restart. True World of Warcraft fans are absolutely loving this. And once again, I highly suggest for you all who haven't exactly experienced WoW to just dive into the adventure while it's still fresh and not a lot of players have all the best things that you can possibly get. But yeah, that's wrapping up this video, everybody. I'm out of here. Thanks for taking the time watching and listening. Hopefully you found this enjoyable. Until next time, peace.